where the core mutations, where the core mutations is really important to understand the core concept of. So I have to look at the reads and the intervening regions that you may not be interested in if your question is specifically about protein sequences. And RNA sequence, you let the cell do the selected exons, which, so in this case, the cell splice out the introns on the reads early on. Exons, they should be mostly the added information about exons and which exons, as the cells are quantitative, so they're very high coverage of genes. Those genes are expressed at a higher level. The genes at a low level are expressed at a higher level. Phrase, on the whole genome sequencing, that's really a bit of a misnomer. We really don't actually measure anything, or more specifically, we have three factor methods to assign every single sequencing read uniquely to a portion to a region of the human genome. Essentially, it's like a chromosome. In this case, there's some tiny, tiny splice here in the chromosome tumor. The genesis of the sequence is the exon mutation splice on this way. This exon means that you're completely confident in where those reads are arriving and our ability to find mutations in those exons. And so, this is your reason why we have to find mutations in every recovery of our power. As we work down the slide, you can see the numbers of mutations.
Thank you.
tumors being a mixture of cancer cells and much of the computations from single base pair changes, now stepping back, looking at much larger changes, gains of whole large regions of the genome, in some cases, whole chromosomes. Here's a microarray, microarray sequencing data, red speed gains that are high level, making application very obvious for sequencing. yourself. I talked a little bit earlier about aligning reads not using Wiki. I'm referring to this example from a blood test project we were involved in which we're actually able to completely reassemble the Epstein-Barr virus and what the diagnosis of lung adenocarcinoma. It's actually turned out not to be lung adenocarcinoma. It was a like lung cancer, the stainless and the tissue of the cancer cells with PBD. But really, this was just data that came off the line of data RNA sequence and was only a change of diagnosis. Just a couple of new slides. This year, all these concepts we talked about RNA sequencing are now applicable and doable at the single cell level. So we now have several commercialized technologies that are now literally using those cells to barcode into two systems, two systems, two gel beads and two unique barcodes. This device is a good thing. Thousands of healthy lung tissues.